Hello everyone, welcome back to the Mitchells in Alaska channel. So I want to give you an update on where we're at right now with the cabin. We've done some more work without getting it videoed, so you can see we have the ridge beam up, and you also see a big catwalk up there that we built to work off of, so we don't have to stand on top of ladders as much. So show you a little bit about what we've done inside. So since the last video, we've installed this window here, which will be in the living room where you can see out through the porch. And so you can see the beams that we milled the other day, that we were doing one of them in that video. So there's that. Again, you can see the ridge beam up there. That thing is 37 feet long, so the thing was a chore. We went ahead and built it on the platform so we wouldn't have to carry it as far. But so anyway, that's up there now. See a lot of other boards hanging down, which are just, those are just temporary handrails we put up there, and we just didn't want to cut the boards up. And you see a couple of supports underneath them beams, which those won't be there either. That's, we just put that up there because with three of us and the beam and the ladders and all the tools up there, we were going to have a lot of weight up there, and those beams really aren't big enough to handle that. So you can see the floor joists are up for the loft. We let that overhang the wall 18 inches just because we like the looks of it. And the other day, the pantry was up, or this front wall was up, but we didn't have the sidewall in it. So now you can see the sidewall in it, so you can actually get a little bit of an idea on size. The pantry is 5 by 10. The bedroom back there is 10 by 25. And it seems kind of big, but in that will also be the bathroom and two walk-in closets. So when you take that out of it, it won't be so big. This part here is the living room and kitchen. The kitchen sink will be underneath that window, so kind of give you an idea. Kitchen countertops will run down this wall right here. So the living room kitchen combination here is 20 by 20. So, and then the loft up there, of course, the floor is a full, is 20 feet wide, but with the pitch of the roof, you can kind of see there, we're on, put an upright wall at wherever 4 foot high comes out to. So I'm guessing that's probably gonna give you about a 10 foot wide room up there is what we're guessing right now. We really haven't measured it out because it just is whatever it's gonna be. So, but what we're getting ready to do now, I'm climbing the ladder, getting up here on this platform, and I'm gonna set my camera up here, and we're gonna cut another rafter and if I can get up here and install another rafter. So you got a pretty good view from up here. You can actually see down through there and see the cabin, the roof of it anyway, or my cabin. So kind of let you see that. So we're getting ready to get at it here. I'm not a fan of heights, so I'm not gonna lie, it scares the hell out of me up here, and especially handling these big old heavy boards. Fred scared death, somebody gonna get knocked off a ladder. So I'm gonna get you set up here best I can where you can see everything that we're doing. Hopefully my phone won't get knocked off of here. Tyler's pulling up another board. We're gonna make a cut on it, or at least get it marked out, and then we're gonna put it in place. So I gotta go help. Got it. Coming at you.
heavy, ain't they? I don't know if you want one more, that'll give us four up here. That'll give us something to do for a little while.
Okay, so now Tyler's hauled up four of these 16-foot 2x10s. So now we're going to start marking them out and put one up.
This one we need to
set this one on top of here.
Yeah, we need to test fit it first or, and make sure we're level across and all that.
Okay. We didn't bring it down here to gauge it either.
No.
We run back and get it.
But we need to run the level across the two of them, don't we? Make sure it's staying square.
Yeah, I think so.
Hate to drag it in and out again, but
yeah.
I don't know what else to do.
Yep.
Well, going through or over?
Yeah, I'll probably go up and over. So I'll get it if you want to get over there. I can get that.
But I can have to get it up here and get it cross laid.
Okay.
Right there. No, we need to make sure we're staying sure level.
No.
From that rafter to those ones?
No.
So we need to kind of get the level.
We need to level over there.
Well, yeah. I guess I either cross.
Sure looks like it's in for the name. Sure looks like it's in for the name.
That's it, sorry, our height size, this way it goes. I guess it'd make a difference if I'm holding that too. Mm-hmm. Okay. I guess that won't tell me that.
Lay it back down and let's make a mark here at 24 inches.
Yeah,
take back the current mark out. Jerry, mark another one.
Not yet. No. To me, it looked like it wasn't right.
So, what's the best way to make sure we're staying flat across there?
I guess you could
measure up. Same amount on both.
Yeah.
I can put the level up through here and let you mark them and go to that same point.
Are you going to do that on the other one?
Yeah.
So it'd be the same if you maybe a touch. I don't know where we're on that. That'd be a way to figure that.
One way I know would be to measure it from the outside over there to the tail, but
up to there.
I don't even know if that's a 100% accurate way of doing it. What about I'm just standing up a 2x or something right there at the short 2x on that ledge. See, you know, roughly where it's at on that one. See where it's at on this one.
On that one.
Yeah, you know, slide it up against the wall and see if you can see about, you know, draw your line across there.
Okay.
Maybe.
Move it over to the other side.
Huh?
Move it over.
I'm gonna measure out 24 inches now.
I need to go from the other side of that.
Yeah. None too much room, is there?
We need any small blocks up there, cut off here, do we?
No. Do what now?
It'll be to the center.
Oh, that'll be the center of this board?
Yeah. I can mark it down here. Line me up.
Yep.
Just get your pencil.
Oh, that one? Yeah, I marked that one down. String going from one end to the other.
If you add, you know, once you got a third one on this side, you can lay a board on there and see if it sets flat.
I guess that's what we're gonna have to do, is take this one back over and mark it. Make one more. Okay.
Yeah. Still high, I may just have to notch those purlins.
Just try to take it over and make a couple of them, or make one more to be able to check it. You know, like a board across three of them. I don't know whether that's a string or something.
Even with a string, you still couldn't do that without the third one.
Yeah.
Even with a setting a board up, sticking up there.
Having a board.
Yeah.
But of that, it's a far from that other one, it'd be hard to.
Well, then you could draw a line straight across from it, that little two by is right at the right spot to bring the line across.
I get you a board, what kind of board you want?
Two by four, good. Two by four?
Yeah, four, how long?
At least 6 inch, 6 to 8 inches.
Yeah, probably needs to, at least 8 inches probably to get. I mean, I don't know if that'll work, that'd just for me.
Yeah.
The little two by is right at the end of it, looks like.
An inch and a half also.
Inch and a half from.
From here.
And from here, I guess a half inch.
I just don't see how that's gonna work.
We just have to have some reference. About an inch and a half out to where that's at.
Yeah, and that's inch and a half right there.
Well, and we set this up here, maybe hold that board up against it and see if it's.
Comes out right at the.
Pretty close.
Beginning of the V.
Yeah. Maybe, I don't know, but to me, it looked like it stuck over a lot farther than that, but I would've guessed what you had there was a half inch too, so.
Drag it up there and see where we're at, see if it's the same. Did you slide down?
About right there, really, where it needs to be.
Is it? This one comes out right in the middle of the two by. Actually, third up on the two by.
So. So we need to cut off some more off of this end?
If we do, I'm afraid it ain't gonna fit up there right. I'd rather like notch the purlins or something in that end one and stuff. Cause it, that way, cause I'm afraid if you cut on it, the angles, you ain't gonna get the angles back right.
Take it over and make, what, one more of them? Or two more, like this?
Yeah, cut one more and have another one marked before you move it, so you don't have to carry it back.
Scoot it on down and check it further down if we want.
Yeah, you can do that.
See if we're coming out about the same and then.
Yeah. We can try that.
Either that or put a tape measure on it, a few places, but yeah.
Yeah, actually, we can do that too. About the easiest thing to do, see what the tape measure shows.
Make sure we're coming out good. Mark.
165 and a half.
165 and a half.
I'll be right time we get to there.
Oh, all over.
The head's shorter.
Cut out one more and mark another one?
Yep. All right, so in case you're wondering what we're trying to do here, as I've said before, we are amateurs and not home builders, so we're having to kind of figure out the rafter thing as we go. So we're doing some trial and error and some test fitting, so that's what we're doing. We pretty much are okay doing the part below the roof, but from the top of the walls up is something we are not very good at and haven't done, hardly ever done any of that. Just take it all the way to your end.
Be fine, mine looks good. I don't have no knots down here. Okay. Good on your end?
Yep.
I'm good. All right, so cut one more, make sure we're good. And then we're good. We'll cut that one.
All right. Now give me some power. Alright, so we're getting ready to cut a couple of rafters here. I'm sure you heard the generator start up.
Both of them are just the ones for now.
I'll go ahead and cut this in where we're at. Cut the other end.
This has got to be kind of like a silent video, isn't it?
There's two nails in the hammer and window sill. Would you hand to me?
I don't want any extra loose pieces up here to stumble over. I sure don't want to fall off the side.
Send one over and put it in place.
They just put a screw up in it like I did last time.
Yeah. So I know to do.
Let's see.
I thought everything was up there, but maybe not.
The screw gun is not. Oh, it's sitting up down there.
Oh, here it is. See what it, where it comes out at also. I'm good down here if you're good there. You look like you might be a hair tall from here anyway. And I can hold it right here where it's at. You're going to climb up the ladder and look. You have to run yours in. I don't have nothing down here to fasten to. Yep. Good to stay.
This is scary for me, I'm telling you. I am not a fan of heights.
Also, on the next one, let's flip that bracket to the way out here, y'all. See how it sits?
Oh, yeah.
That way it gives it. It sits on a loop. That's what I done over there. Staggered them. Send another one?
Yeah, we got another here in the center.
Still got another one besides that one, Mark?
Yeah.
We do.
Okay.
You got another bracket?
Yep.
Another one. Enough for you?
Yeah.
And that upset?
Mm-hmm.
I need 48 too. Yep. You good?
Ready.
We will have to get down to this one. There's several more to go after this one, so after this one I'll put my board back. There?
Yep.
Screw man.
That'll hold it, boy.
Yep, yep. Yep, you're free. You're in topple.
Yep.
to look like a roof.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now you should be able to lay your level on these two and see what it is from the side down.
Yeah, ain't long enough to span them, is it?
No.
Should be, 4 foot. I don't know, we'd slide off, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I bet it will span. Is it touching all of them?
Looks good to me.
Good enough.
Yeah. Man, I'm within an eighth of an inch.
Yeah, that's good enough.
I'm gonna cut another one or two and...
Well, we need to do the other. Kind of want to stay evenly, don't you? I haven't done enough of it to know, but...
Get too many to push that one.
That's what I was afraid to push it, yeah.
Alright. So what do you want to do then? You want to...
We gotta take that one down and...
Take that one down, mark another one.
Uh-huh. Well, you need to mark your... We need to go cut the D-logs.
I just gotta mark them.
I just gotta mark them. And cut that top one?
Yeah, I gotta cut the top one.
Need the drill?
Impact driver.
Okay, so here's where we are right now. We've got three rafters up on the one side, which you can kind of see there. We have one up over here that's going to work for a pattern, but the top log that sticks out there, he has to cut it off, because to scoot that one over to where it needs to be, that log's in the way of it, so, which is right down there on the bottom, you can see. So anyway, we're gonna stop this video now, and I'll try to record some more as we get a little bit further along. But 40 minutes of sitting here watching this has got to be pretty boring. So anyway, we'll post you with another one. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you would.